Now, a severe thunderstorm warning has been issued for the northern parts of Greenup County. Not a tornado warning at the moment. So we'll inspect this here in just a moment. But let me go ahead and track this storm for you. The track indicates it will be at 1218 at Beachy. So Beachy, you need to be prepared to take your tornado safety precautions at this time. Also, we're looking at this thunderstorm capable producing some very gusty winds that are actually moving into Portsmouth right now. The very strong gusty winds that are possibly severe will be moving into Wheelersburg as well. But the tornadic portion that we have been watching has been here. It's now moving across the county line into Greenup County. So we're going to zoom in here just a little bit more. You can see the storm track, and it's going to be at the Greenup Locks and Dam at 1225. At 1225 this afternoon, as we're looking at this thunderstorm, radar indicated capable of producing a tornado. Now, we'll move in here just a little bit closer so we can get a better idea of the storm. We'll take the storm track off here so I can move over here to what we call our velocity product. This is where we're able to look at the wind spinning up. And if there is going to be any tornado, it will be right here, and it's going to be moving into Beachy. And that is going to be, we're going to identify the street here for you, identify this road here so you can get a good idea as this thunderstorm complex continues to move through. This is State Highway 10. So this is moving right along State Highway 10 into Beachy, and there's winds that are twisting right here. The green indicates the radar is up here in Wilmington, Ohio. The green indicates winds that are moving towards the radar. The red indicates winds that are moving away from the radar. And as this starts to spin here, there at least should be a wall cloud. And that's going to be clouds that are hanging low outside below this thunderstorm. And you might be able to see a funnel as it moves toward Beachy. But there's just a severe thunderstorm warning that's been issued for northern parts of Greenup County. The tornado warning does include Scioto County. So while there might be a little bit of a discrepancy here, still, this is a severe thunderstorm that's capable of producing some very gusty winds and also the possibility of some hail that we're going to continue to monitor. Matter of fact, let's show you exactly what's happening here on Storm Tracker 13 HD Dual Live Doppler Radar. This is what we call our triple threat indicator. And this is indicating possibly quarter-size hail moving into Portsmouth. Downtown Portsmouth, hail is moving in right now, along with some very heavy rainfall. Wheelersburg, you need to be on the lookout within the next 10, 15 minutes at the latest. Within about the next 10 minutes, very heavy rainfall and possibly up to quarter-size hail moving into the area. Plus, you're also going to see some very heavy rain with some gusty winds occurring across this area. This is where we're looking at the tornadic portion of the thunderstorm right here along State Highway 10 moving into Beachy, but some strong winds right here around Portsmouth. Here's a look at your tornado safety tips. You need to take shelter in a basement or a cellar, so that means you need to go below ground if you can. That's the safest place, especially for northern parts of Greenup County at the moment. You need to either be in a closet or a hallway. And when you go into that closet or hallway, the basement, or even for that matter, your cellar, you take with you blankets and a pillow, and you put them over your head. You stay away from windows, extremely dangerous to be near those, and inside a mobile home, they're not safe. 99% of the year, they're a great place to live, but they are not safe when it comes to a tornado. Our weather eye across eastern Kentucky, what we're looking at are some of the clearing skies, and we do have the clouds. These cumulus clouds are popping up, so they're really starting to fuel the fire. The sun is for the juicy atmosphere as we get into late this afternoon, this evening. Charleston, GW High, while we do have mostly sunny skies developing, that's not good news for thunderstorms to develop later in the day. Here's a look at Storm Tracker 13 HD Dual Live Doppler Radar. The loop shows you this thunderstorm. It really starts to develop as it gets here into Adams County, and it's crossing the line of parts of Scioto County as well as Greenup County and Lewis County. So it's moving right towards Beachy, Wheelersburg, as we said, Portsmouth. You've got the heavy rain, the thunderstorms, and the windy conditions. Now, this is the entire complex. What you see is most of the complex falling apart, but here the strongest thunderstorms are right here along the Ohio River. I think this is round one that's developing. We've got another round that's going to develop behind that, and it's all within this warm sector. South of this warm front doesn't mean good news for us. Our tornado threat with thunderstorms that develop today will be around 5%. So that's very low, but still, obviously, we have that tornado issue right here along the Greenup as well as Scioto County line. With Predictor, let's time this out for you today. we get you to 4 o'clock. Strong to severe thunderstorms moving north of Charleston. And then there's another line that's developing back to the west. 6:30, watch this line start to move across the region. This will produce some extremely strong winds, possibly in excess of 60 miles an hour as we get into late this afternoon, tonight. That's 9 o'clock. Then we go to 11 o'clock, news time. What you're seeing are strong thunderstorms across southeastern Kentucky and southern parts of West Virginia. Another round of thunderstorms, some showers continuing into the overnight hours. So with that being said, our forecast for today, severe storms are possible with a high temperature of 85. We'll continue to monitor the situation with the latest on the severe thunderstorm warning for Greenup County and also tornado warning for Scioto County until 12:45. We'll be back with more. Keep it here. We'll keep you advised.
Now, Storm Tracker 13 with the area's most powerful HD live Doppler radar.
It is 12:09 and we're looking at showers and thunderstorms developing as we head into this afternoon. Some of those could be strong to severe. The primary threats out of today's thunderstorms would be very gusty winds. Now let's take a look at what's happening on Storm Tracker 13 HD dual live Doppler radar, the most powerful radar in the region. And you can see showers and storms have developed northwest of Columbus. Also, a few showers and storms just north and northwest of Dayton across parts of Indiana. These thunderstorms are not in the best environment for severe weather to develop. They need to move a little bit further south for us to see some real good shower and thunderstorm development. I'll show you that here in just a moment with the satellite imagery, but let's zoom in here just a hair bit closer on the high resolution radar imagery, a bit closer to home, and you can see we do have a few sprinkles that have developed across parts of Jackson, Roan County, Wirt County, as well as Clay County. These are all moving off to the east right now. Very, very light sprinkles, but for the most part, we're dealing with quite a few clouds across the area, and that's what limits our initial severe weather development for the day are the clouds. But there's some clearing back to the northwest that we're continuing to watch. So you can see mostly cloudy skies in Charleston. We do have mostly cloudy skies across parts of eastern Kentucky as well. Here's a look at the temperatures. 75 Charleston, Hamlin, Huntington, Hurricane. We have 73 Jackson and Point Pleasant, 73 in Sutton. So mid 70s. We're on target for our temperatures that we're expecting in the low 80s for today. But here's the clouds and radar over the last 4 hours. What I mentioned, clouds. Clouds limit our severe weather potential. But there's this area of clearing right here across southern and south central parts of Ohio. Now, if we start to see more of this area clear up and this clearing expand just a little bit, that's going to add some fuel to the fire for these thunderstorms because they start to work their way into a more favorable environment for showers and thunderstorms to develop, which will be actually right here across parts of West Virginia, southern Ohio, and eastern sections of Kentucky. But this would be the initial round of strong thunderstorms that we have the possibility for as we go into our midday. And then as we get into this evening, we have possibly even a second round of weather that we'll have to keep our eyes on. The Storm Prediction Center in Norman, Oklahoma, they issue severe thunderstorm watches, tornado watches. They also issue a storm risk, and there are 4 levels of it. General thunderstorms, slight, moderate, and high risk for severe weather. We're in the slight risk for severe weather, with our primary threats being very gusty winds and some hail with some of the thunderstorms that develop as we head to this afternoon. So here's a look at Predictor, and we're expecting showers and thunderstorms by 5-6 o'clock to be numerous across the area. You can see 6:30 showers and thunderstorms lining up along I-64. Then we get into late this evening, showers and thunderstorms continue across eastern Kentucky, southern West Virginia. Overnight, there may even be another round of weather happening across the region. So that's something we're going to keep our eyes on. Here's a look ahead at Riverfront Park as they are actually, city workers are out there cleaning up the park. They're actually putting in the electric for the big boats to show up as we get into tomorrow, because tomorrow is when the big boats can start to show up. But anyways, 83 for today with the showers and thunderstorms heading into the mid-afternoon and also this evening. 79 for your Thursday with some morning showers. And then Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, we're looking at temperatures warming up as we have a dry Memorial Day weekend. That river is going to be running rampant with boats and people out and about there.
Yes, I'm sure it will be.
Yeah, yes, but the thunderstorms, like I said, gusty winds a primary threat. With the strongest thunderstorms, some of those wind gusts could be 50 to even up to 70 miles an hour. Not going to be anything like what we saw a couple years ago, but still something we're going to keep our eyes on. We'll be fully staffed.
All right, thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Now, Now, Storm Tracker 13 with the area's most powerful HD live Doppler radar.
Good morning and welcome back to Point Pleasant. The sun is shining. It's beautiful as we start this Friday. Saturday is going to be nice and toasty. Lots of sunshine as well. But then things kind of go downhill Sunday into Monday. Let's quickly check out what's happening in regards to your temperatures across the area. Right now, we're looking at 59 degrees here in Point Pleasant. We've also got temperatures 62 in Charleston, Huntington 63, down in Pikeville 65, Logan 62, down in Lincoln County. And, these kids are not happy about Lincoln County. Hamlin, 63 degrees. But Lincoln County, you better bring it as you head into tonight because Point Pleasant is coming to town. It's now 62. We continue that temperature to 8 a.m. as we go hour by hour noon. We have partly sunny skies and 82 degrees. And then we have 88 degrees as we get to 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock. Gotta be nice. By the way, just so you know, for the rest of you, band members, we weren't just going to feed the football team. We've got tutors, and I mean a bunch of tutors for everybody else. So don't worry, there's more where that came from.
Let's turn to meteorologist Brian Hughes.
Well, it is not looking pretty out there for many folks, and a lot of this is not necessarily because of just the snow that's coming down now. It's because of that ice that we've been warning you about for many, many days. As we told you, there would be an ice storm that is now being followed up by a snowstorm. So it's one big winter storm that's just walloping the region. Here's the issue primarily that we're going to deal with for this morning. It is going to be the cold temperatures that's really not going to allow any of this stuff to melt at all. Salt works to about 14 degrees. So salt is going to work, but remember, we have reports of not a lot of salt around the area, and trying to spread that stuff pretty thin, well, either all the supplies are going to be diminished this time around, or still we've got to hang on to it for a little bit longer. 18 Huntington Hurricane, 20 Charleston, 15 Point Pleasant, 17 Spencer. Here's a look at Storm Tracker 13, HD Dual Live Doppler Radar. And what we're looking at now, you can see this pink shaded and purple shaded area, that's where the sleet and freezing rain is occurring. It's slowly moving to the south now across southern portions of Pike County, Kentucky, as well as into southern Mingo and Logan counties, Wyoming, McDowell, back down into Raleigh County. But we have snow bands, one right after another. Some of them are heavy across Prestonburg, stretching back up to Logan with a few ice crystals mixed in. But then looky here. Here's another new snow band that we're watching that continues to move south. Hey, if you think we're not the only ones getting it, Morgantown. This is a live picture of coming from Morgantown. So if you got kids up there at WVU, they dealt with a lot of snow yesterday. They're still dealing with some of the snow this morning. And here's what we're looking at for some of our snow totals, 2 to 5 inches across the light shaded blue, 4 to 8. The further south you go, 6 to 10. And this snow continues on into early this afternoon. Our forecast, let's plan it out for you. 10 a.m., 16, the snow continues. By noon, we're at 18 with the snow ending in 23 at 4 o'clock. We're partly cloudy skies, so there is some ray of sunshine. There's a ray of sun at the end of the tunnel. I promise you that. Checking in on some of the latest radar data and what's happening across the region is our own chief meteorologist, Spencer Atkins, and he is going to come here in just a moment. But first of all, we've got to check in with Jack and Courtney on what's happening across the area. We'll check in with Spencer in a moment.
All right. Thank you, Brian.